Adobe's just dropped a new update to Photoshop. It's July 2024. Let's have a look at the new features right now. So the first thing we need to do is update. Go to Creative Cloud at the top on Mac. You'll find that at the bottom on Windows. So click on Apps, and then you want to choose View Updates. Under Update, you'll see Photoshop. Click on Update now. So if this was a full version, like say 26, you would get an additional installation of Photoshop. Because this is a dot release 25.11, it's going to update the existing version of Photoshop and you'll open it from the same icon. I usually skip the home screen. If you want to go to Photoshop from the home screen, hit PS. Now you may not see the tools showing up in the toolbar the first time. If you click this little menu here and then choose Edit Toolbar, any new tools will show up here in the extra tools and also at the bottom. Quickest way to do that is to just choose Restore Defaults and then click Done, and now your menu bar should be set up. If you've created custom workspaces, make sure you resave those because those old workspaces are not going to contain the new tools. All right, let's look at the features. So I'm just going to give you an overview of the new features right now, and in another video, we'll target specific ones and go deeper. So the first new feature is the Selection Brush. If we go under the Lasso tool, you'll see Selection Brush tool here. This enables us to brush on an adjustment. Yes, it works exactly the same as Quick Mask. And honestly, if I can give my opinion, I prefer Quick Mask over this, but it does have a couple of things it can do. There's no auto detection in this. You simply just paint, and then wherever you paint can become a selection. So you just have to choose another tool and now it becomes a selection. So to me, it works pretty much like a Quick Mask, but it has less features. But it is easy to use. All right, so let's have a look at some of the things it can do that make it more useful than regular selections. So let's go under the hardness. So if we choose the brush settings, we can take the hardness all the way down. Now, this makes it very, very easy to do a softer selection. We can also drop the opacity, so it's gonna fade it back a little bit. Let's take it to about 80. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna kind of paint in this area here. We'll just do a rough kind of a collage effect just to show how it works. All right, so I've made that selection there. So we could go in here and apply it to certain filters. So if we choose filter blur and grab say like a Gaussian blur or something like that, we could use it to filter certain areas like this. I'm just gonna hit the escape because I don't wanna do that right now. What I wanna do is I wanna just create a new layer mask. So let's hit the layer mask and notice it'll mask out that area and that'll give us a kind of a nice compositing kind of a feel. Now, if we invert this, select the mask, hit Control I, now we've got this open area where we could drop something else in there if we wanted. So let's grab this elephant here, and I'm just going to grab one of the tools and just choose remove background, and then we're just going to grab this with the move tool and let's just drag it in. So drag it up the tab of the one we want to go to, move it into the middle, hold down the shift key to center it, release. All right, we've got an elephant there, but let's drop our elephant underneath, dragging it underneath there. Now we want to go to Free Transform. We can actually just go up here to the taskbar. We can turn it on, grab the Alt or Option key to center it, and then we're just going to drag out and we're going to make this big elephant. We could just kind of move it around. And you get the general idea. And we could put a colored background in if we wanted. Let's just choose a solid color. And why don't we sample something off our image, that brownish tone. Click OK. Make sure that's at the bottom. And you get the general idea. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. Okay, let's look at a situation where this selection brush does work really well and it is actually easier to use than Quick Mask in this particular scenario. So what we're going to do is let's add a underwater shark in this image. So what we want to do is let's make the brush hard just to give it that edge. And I'm going to drop the opacity down to, I don't know, about 30% or somewhere around there. Close enough. And let's just kind of paint in this area here. Let's type in shark. And generate. All right, and then we have some sharks here that look like they're underwater a little bit. Now, if we were to just change the transparency, you would see the waves and things behind them, whereas it's generating with the density makes it look like it's underwater without the background revealing through it. Next new tool has a couple of little updates to it. And that is the adjustment brush. So if we go down in the panel here, you'll see that the adjustment brush is now is its own tool inside the toolbar. And this is a good thing because of those of you who use the brush, When you'd hit the B key, it would choose the adjustment brush and it would mess up your workflow. So I'm really happy this is done. I'm just going to quickly show you how this works. I've got other tutorials I've done on this. So I'm not going to get too far. But one of the things that's nice in here now, so we can choose what type of adjustment we want to do from the taskbar here. And also we got brush settings, so we can do size and hardness right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to use the selection tool and just briefly show you how this works. So maybe I'll make a selection around those buildings. I'm not trying to make this perfect, just so you know. But see what it did is it made it that adjustment right there. So if we adjust the brightness, you can see what it did is it created a brand new layer, popped a mask on it. Now, if we want to add to that, just grab this tool with that same layer selected. And, you know, we could just drag over some other buildings. And you'll see it just kind of picked those up. And once again, I'm not going to go too far in this. Check out my other tutorials on that. All right, let me show you a couple of features together that I've been wanting for a long time. So let's just grab the first one. I'm going to do a rectangle. I want to do some kind of a rectangle. We're going to choose the shape tool. And what I want to do is just kind of draw over here. We'll just do a slide, basically. All right, so now you'll notice here under the taskbar, we can change things. So we could go in here and we could do the fill. We could change that. We could, you know, set this stroke directly in here. Just turn that stroke off if we want. Or just put, let's put a thin little, I don't know, there. Let's adjust the size of it. And directly within here, we can do things like adjust the corner radius. Okay, so we could type in a radius or we could just click and drag here to change those corner radius. If you wanted to do one separate, we could just click on this one and drag it over and look at that. See how we can adjust those. So we have a little bit more control over these shapes. Make sure you select shape up here and not path or pixels for that to work. But let me show you another one that I'm just really excited about. So let's grab the type tool here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold down the shift key so I can just click and add normal type. Right, so if you ever wanted to do bullets or numbers in here, you had to create those individually inside of Photoshop. So one of the new features is if we click this little icon here, you will see. So if we go to paragraph, you'll see we now have the ability to add bullets. Look at that. So simple, but man, so glad that's there. And of course, if we wanted, we could change that into a numbered list right there. And if we added another one, we just type in, just hit the carriage return and another tip. This is a small one, but also in my opinion, this is a huge one. And by the way, if you want to indent them, just select them and then just drag over here a little bit. Okay, a couple more that have actually made their way over from beta into Photoshop. Let's grab our selection brush. All right, the selection brush, let's just make a quick selection around here. And what we're going to do is hit generate fill and let's type in boat. And hit generate. Not really too worried what kind of boats are going to be generated. I just want to demonstrate this feature. Now I have gone more in depth in this in other videos. All right, so let's have a look at a couple of variations. All right, so say this one here. If we look at the edge of where it was generated, notice it's a little pixely around there because of the resolution. A feature that's been brought over from beta now is we can click here and we can enhance the image. And as you can see, it just adds a little bit more detail and simulates resolution. So I've done another video on this where I go super in depth and I show you what's actually really happening. Check out that video. And the last new feature I want to show you is generate image. Now, if you reset your workflow like I did at the beginning, you should see a new box at the bottom here. And if we click on this, this enables us to generate an image. Once again, this has come over from Photoshop beta. It's now in the full version and I've gone super in depth into this as well. But let's have a look. Let's do a cat drinking. All right, who knows what we're going to get. We're going to have a cat drinking a cup of coffee while singing. We could create this as art or we could create it as a photo. We can use reference images. So we can choose that. We can choose, you know, different types of effects. So maybe we want to do a movement and we want to make it maybe more of an Art Nouveau kind of style. So there's a lot of different effects and stuff like that. But rather than going in depth here, I would say just check out my tutorial that I've done on this where I go in depth. And then we're just going to hit generate. And this is going to create a brand new image. And here we go. So notice this created a new layer on top. So it's actually going to use, that's actually pretty good. That one's actually not bad. It's pretty funny. So this generates at a 2K resolution, but it will generate at the size of whatever document you're working in. And you'll notice if there's no document open, the generate image is going to be grayed out. So you need to either use it on an existing document or just create a new one. So if you just choose File New, choose the size that you want to work from, say 1920 by 1080, and then click Create. Now we're able to generate an image inside this new document. So I hope you enjoyed this brief overview. Let me know in the comments underneath which are your favorite new features and which ones would you like to see me dig much more in depth into where I'll make some more videos. Anyway, if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.